These are a series of poems that I've met that I've been writing about fictional meetings with people of note. It's called Hero Worship. This is part one. George Orwell once shot an elephant for reasons tantamount to peer pressure. George Orwell is my hero, I explained to the zookeeper. Part two, and this might be upsetting if you or any members of your family have ever died because of prolonged exposure to the radioactive elements that you were discovering. Marie and Pierre Curie are killing each other with love, but nevertheless, I feel unable to comment because I have never been in love. In many ways, I am green with envy. In one specific way, they are starting to go green per se. And this is part three, which... oh, that's very half-hearted. This is part three, which might only work if you know the poem that it's based on. But it's a very famous poem. There's got to be one English student in here. So, William Blake and I have ventured into the forest of the night. It was his choice, then ask. But it's just off Junction 7 on the M56, if you want to go. William Blake is good company, all things considered. I would give him a strong 6 out of 10. Watch out, John, he says suddenly. My name is not John, but I've missed the juncture, which is acceptable to correct him, but it's fine, it's fine. Now, honestly, it's fine. What is it now, Will? I ask through gritted teeth. He does not notice, as all teeth were heavily gritted as a matter of course during the Industrial Revolution. Don't turn around, but I fear there is behind you a tiger. A what, sorry, I ask. A tiger, John. A tiger. I wince slightly as he gets my name wrong again, but he does not notice, as they hadn't invented body language during the Industrial Revolution. Still not getting it. Say again. A tiger. Animal burns brightly, has fearful symmetry. A tickle of fear touches me in the spine because though all animals, bar three-legged dogs, are essentially symmetrical, I know of only one that is fearfully so. Look, are you saying tiger? I ask. Yes, tiger, tiger. It's still not hitting my ear, right? Why are you saying it like that? Go on, say it again. Tiger. Slower. Tiger. I think I've narrowed down the problem. How are you spelling it? I ask. T. Mm-hmm. Y. T-Y, I ask. T-Y-G-E-R, he says. T-Y. T-Y. You think T-Y. You think tiger is T-Y. You can't just make... You can't just make up spellings. After T-Y-J-J-U-R-T-T-Y. I think I'm probably safe in making fun of his spelling, as I didn't have a proper conception of dyslexia during the Industrial Revolution. T-Y. It's only 5 letters to get right, Will. T-Y. I think I'm not as okay with the John thing as I made out.